think in the last, you know, 8 years, there have been, I think, three times where a team's gone from last place to actually winning the league or being tied for first in the league. So, you know, you can go from worst to first or first to worst, and you know, it's only a matter of a couple goals here and there.
Top to bottom, it's a dogfight week in, week out. You know, guys are doing a good job, and you're seeing everybody beat everybody, which is a pretty neat dynamic. Plus, you root for the league because you see teams beat other big-time programs, and that's good for all of us. So it's really an exciting time for the Aggies.
The coaching is great. I mean, they're great coaches at every school. The school will support it because they know we can compete at the highest level. And so when you combine the support, the coaching, and the athletes and the talent, I think it's why we are as competitive as we are amongst ourselves and each other, and also against the rest of the country. So.
Yale is a wonderful program. They're well coached. You know, they've beaten us the last 2 years in a conference championship game, and candidly, this past year it ended our season. So we have a ton of respect for them. You know, the whole league is as good as it gets, really. You know, top to bottom.
You know, I think our model has always been, and will continue to be, just working on the little things and working day to day, and just trying to get better. And then, you know, if we can look back on the prior season and it is what we hoped it would be, then we did it the right way. We try not to get too far ahead and try to, you know, think too far past the first game or even the first practice. You know, I think when you do that, you start looking into the future too much, then you stumble a little bit. And that's really been our mantra for the last few years, and there's no reason to stray away from that.
Yes, I think we can be in the top tier of the Ivy League and get back to the Ivy League tournament. But at the same time, all seven teams are very good. You know, you had teams that finished toward the bottom that beat teams at the top. It's been consistent, you know, in the 4 years that we've had an Ivy tournament. So, you know, again, back to being consistent. You know, if we can be consistent, what we're trying to do with the players that we have, I think we can be the top half or in that group of four that makes the Ivy tournament. But again, we have to play well, so time will tell.
We have high expectations. I mean, you know, the thing about Princeton is it's part of the DNA. You know, you shoot for the very top because it's been done there six times. But this group certainly hasn't done it. I haven't done it. We have a good team. You know, we think we have the ability to compete at a very high level, but we got a lot of work to do. You know, we just do. We have some new faces we got to mix in. We've got some plenty of questions that need answering. But it's a committed group that you know has its sights set on being as good as it can be. And I think you know, time will tell. Tom's just so multidimensional. You know, he's as explosive as they come. You know, he's just a big, strong, physical athlete. He can shoot the ball, create his own shot really whenever he wants it. But I think, you know, having the vision that he does, you know, he can distribute the ball and make everybody else around him better. So
I think Schreiber's fantastic. You don't really game plan for him. It's not somebody you try to take out of the game. You just try to minimize his impact as best you can.
He's explosive. He's unbelievably skilled. You know, he can do just about anything. He plays on both sides of the field. He's a great feeder. I think he's a great team player.
Who I personally think is as good as there is in the United States. He had three games last year. He was over 80%. His save percentage was 50, high 50s somewhere. And we have the second hardest strength of schedule in the country. So. I think Brian Feeney is absolutely fantastic.